deuce or an ace. With Lady Luck, you'll win the race on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you, Jan. Thank you very much. Welcome to Card Sharks. Nice to have you here. You're very kind. And our thanks, too, to Joy Sally of Belton, Texas, for that opening poem. Thank you, Joy. Now let's open the board and get to the cards. And Janice and Marky, if you will, start loading in the cards. We're starting a new game with these Card Sharks. Hello, Steve Hanks, our champion. Nice to see you again, Steve.
Good to see you, too.
You're looking well. Our
gentleman
from Florida, you know, we were kidding on the last show, and you were saying about always living in the Sun Belts. Have you never lived in the North where it gets cold in the winter?
The only time I was in the North was when I was born there, and I was born in Ohio. That's as far north as I've ever been.
Now you kind of like it in the South there, huh?
I love it.
Steve, you're doing very well with us. You've won $1,300, $1,300, which is nice.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you again. Our challenger, Michelle Stevens. Hello, Michelle. Nice to see you. And won't you again remind us about yourself?
Yes, I just moved here from New Jersey, and I love it here because I love the weather, and I love to gamble. Vegas and the racetrack, I just love it.
Terrific, and you're doing well here. Are you comfortable?
Yeah.
Enjoying it?
Yeah.
Good, we play the best 2 out of 3, and as we left off, Steve won game number one. So, Michelle, if you want to play Vegas here, you got to get going.
Okay.
Good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
And the cards have been shuffled, the players cut them. Steve, the champion, will play the upper cards, the red cards, and Michelle, the challenger, plays the lower cards, the blue cards. As we left off, the question goes to you, Steve. Steve, we asked 100 bachelors. On your last date, you're a bachelor, Steve, right?
Yes, sir.
This is not you, but those 100 bachelors. On your last date, did you experience the thrill of victory or the agony of defeat? How many bachelors admitted they experienced the agony of defeat?
Out of all the bachelors I know, a lot of them have been defeated a lot more than they've won. So I'm going to have to say 45.
45 have experienced the agony of defeat. Michelle, higher or lower?
I'm going to say lower because I think that a lot of them, probably even more, have experienced it, but they wouldn't admit it.
Oh, okay. So. Well, it's always a confidential poll, but let's find out. Michelle, if it is lower, you'll go to the board first. If not, it'll be Steve. And the actual number of bachelors who experienced the agony of defeat on their last date is... 35. You're right, Michelle. It's lower. And you get the first crack of the cards. You start with a jack.
Okay, I'll keep that jack and I'll go lower.
Lower than a jack? Oh, no, an ace. It's not lower, and that gives Steve a free chance to play off a 5.
Okay, I believe the next card is higher.
Higher than a 5? Yes, with a queen.
All right. Okay, I believe the next card is lower. Let's go lower. Let's go
lower. Lower than a queen. It is a 4.
The next card is higher. Let's keep going.
Higher than a 4.
Get up.
A 9.
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze it. And we'll move over the freeze bar. We can't take those cards away from you. And Michelle, as Janice fills in the space. Michelle, we found 100 women who have been divorced 3 or more times. And we asked them, are you better now at picking a husband than when you first started out? How many divorcees said they are still no better at choosing a husband?
Let's see. I'm going to say about 60%. 60 said they're no better because if they tried 3 times and they, you know, after 3 times they haven't picked the right one, they're probably pretty down in the dumps now.
So you figure they haven't improved.
Yeah.
She says 60 are no better at picking a husband, Steve.
I think it would be higher because I think they'd be more skillful at picking one, but I think they'd be less willing. But I still would say higher.
Okay. The actual number of divorced women who are no better at choosing a husband is 26, not higher, Michelle. I guess they figured they learned something along the way. Michelle, you've got a jack.
Lower.
You're going to play the jack lower, and you're right with a 10.
Okay, lower.
Lower than a 10. Oh, no, it's a queen. And again, Michelle takes a chance, and it does not pay off. With a 9, Steve, call this one for the win.
I will go against the odds. I think the next card's higher.
If this is higher, Steve, you won the championship. You'll play the money cards for the win. No, it is not higher, and Michelle gets a reprieve. Question 3. Steve, we asked 100 grown men. When you take a bath, grown men, when you take a bath, do you have a favorite toy you play with in the tub? How many men said yes
That's got to be way low. I will have to say four.
Four. Four.
Yeah, four.
Four. Four. Michelle?
I'm going to say, I guess lower, because I never heard of anyone. At least I hope my husband doesn't. I don't know about any such toy. Anyway,
no, so you say it's even lower
even
than
lower.
Lower than four, huh? My rubber ducky is going to be so insulted. The actual number of men who admitted they have a favorite toy they play with when they take a bath is six. It's not lower, Steve, but it's still a very low number. Now then, Steve, you could change that nine if you'd like.
Please change the nine, yes.
You won the question. You have the right to change it. Two. A two, a great change.
The next card is higher.
For the championship, yes. Higher than a two, it is a king. Steve wins it, and he'll play in the money cards. Michelle, thank you so much for joining us. Hope you had fun. Be careful when you go to Las Vegas. Watch that gambling. Michelle Stevens. Steve, come on down here. Steve Hanks, go on for the big money with the money cards right after this commercial break. Way to go.
Now you've got to be ready. This has got to be it.
We are back with our champion, Steve Hanks. And Steve, the money cards haven't been too kind to you up to now.
That's until now. This time we're going for it.
That's the way to feel. Let's get to the money cards. Come on, Steve. We hope they're going to turn around for you. Money cards all shuffled and cut. We'll start dealing out, giving you $200 on the bottom line and three cards. When you move up to the second level, another $200 of betting money, three more cards. Remember, your minimum bet's $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet, and there you must bet at least half the money. Steve, let's do it this time. Here's $200. As in the game, you have a choice of two base cards to start with. Remember, you can change your base card if you'd like on the next two levels if you need to. Right now, with $200, you have a six.
Okay, change the six, please.
Next card off the top of the deck. Got to play this one. Oh, yes, an ace.
Good. All right, thanks so much. Give me $200 if the card's lower.
All of it, $200 lower than an ace. Yes, with a 10, doubling it to 400.
All right, I want to bet $100, please, if the next card's lower.
$100 lower than a 10. Oh, it's a queen.
Right.
Down to 300 with a queen.
Let me bet $300 if the next card's lower.
He's betting it all. $300 lower than a queen. No! You win those cards, but you're not out of it, Steve, because you've got the other $200 of betting money. Up goes the big ace. You're back in it.
I'll bet $200 the next card's lower.
All of it lower than an ace. Yes! $400 again. Still three cards to go.
$50, next card's higher.
$50 higher than a 7. It is a 9 for 50.
Okay, I'll bet $50, next card's lower.
Let's get it much lower. $50 lower than a 9. No, it's a jack. Down to $400. You've always seemed to struggle with these, Steve, but let's top it off now. You got a jack? Do you want to play that?
$200, next card's lower.
You're going to bet half the money playing the jack. Lower than a jack.
Yeah. Don't give me a heart attack.
Yes! All right. $600. Oh, you made a comeback. Steve, yes, and if that had not gone for you, that would have been terrible. Come on down here, Steve. Steve, you inch along there, but you are up to an even round $2,000 in cash right now. That's not too bad, Steve Hanks.
That's all right. Thanks.
We'll meet a new challenger right after this. Always something goes against you over there. Okay, Steve, time to defend the title. Janice is dealing out two brand new decks of cards, and we'll meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. Linda Aldred. Hello, Linda. Welcome.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to have you here. Won't you tell us about yourself?
I live in Bakersfield, California. I am originally from Houston, Texas. I'm a loan officer for a mortgage company. I'm married, and I played pro football when I was in college.
You did what?
I played pro football. During the summer when I was in college, I was a left halfback.
Pro football?
Yes.
What kind of a league is this?
It was a ladies' team in Houston, and we all got together, and we made a little money, and then the majority of the money we gave to charity. And I was a left halfback, and my best game, I gained 168 yards rushing.
That's terrific. May I tell you, Linda, you are so much prettier than O.J. Simpson. It is incredible.
Thank you.
Good to have you here, Linda. You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Steve, the champion, the upper cards, the red cards. And we'll start the best two out of three match with a question to Steve. We found 100 women executives, Steve. Now, these women are all vice presidents of corporations. And we asked them, who's the boss in your house, you or your husband? How many women executives said that they are the boss?
To get to that high executive position, you got to have some smarts. And to keep a marriage alive, you got to let the man think that he's the boss. Okay? So, now that I've said all that, I forgot completely what the question was.
How many women executives said that they, the woman, are the boss?
Okay, they are not. They let him think he's a boss, but they don't actually, they are 45.
Would you like an instant replay of that, friends? He says 45, Liz.
Steve kind of confused me. Would you mind repeating it again?
I'm sorry. I can't imagine why. Women executives, all vice presidents of corporations, who's the boss in your house, you or your husband? How many women executives says that they, the woman, are the boss?
I would say that it's a little lower.
Lower than 45.
Yes, definitely.
The actual number of women executives who are the boss in their house is 24. You're right, Linda. It's lower. And Linda, you start off with a jack.
I think I'm going to keep the jack and go lower.
Lower than a jack? Oh, no, it's a queen. And a chance again for Steve to play an eight.
Okay.
You didn't win the question. You cannot change it.
I'm going to go higher with that eight.
Higher than an eight.
Yep.
Yes, a queen.
Okay, I'll go. Keep going lower with the queen.
Lower than a queen. It is a 10.
Freeze.
Freezing it.
Freeze.
And we move over to the freeze bar and fill in the space for Linda. Linda, your first question, and we've asked 100 married men. Do you find that you occasionally have to lie to your wife to make your marriage work? How many married men said yes, they have to lie occasionally?
Although I believe in honesty, my husband sometimes, I think, lies to me, white lies to me, to make everything amicable. So I'm going to say that's a middle-of-the-road number, let's say 61.
Do you recommend it to keep a marriage going, a little white lie occasionally?
Yes. I'm a difficult person at times.
Linda says 61.
I believe in the honesty of everyone. I really do. I hate to keep saying that, but I'm going to have to say it's lower than 61.
Lower. Well, the actual number of men who lie to the wife to make their marriage work is 37. Steve, you're right. It's lower.
I didn't like that 10 last time. I don't like it now. Please change it. Yeah.
Wants to change the 10 to a 3.
Okay.
Good change.
The next card is higher.
Higher than a 3. Yes, a 6.
I'll freeze.
Freezing it, needing one card for the first game. And the question to you, Steve. Steve, we asked 100 bachelors. Boy, you get these bachelor questions. When you go out with a girl for the first time, do you smell your own breath before you knock on the door? How many bachelors said, yeah, they check their breath?
No reasons. 60.
60. Okay. No questions. Linda.
I had a date that did that one time, and I thought he was kind of weird. I think it's a little bit lower.
Think it's lower?
Yes. I would hope so.
The actual number of bachelors who check their breath before they knock on their date's door is 44. It's lower, Linda. Yeah. There's still a lot of people. I guess we all have our little insecurities. Linda, you've got a jack.
Okay, the jack wasn't good to me last time, but I'm going to keep it and go lower.
Lower than a jack? This time it's
good
for you with 3.
Higher.
Higher than a 3. Yes, a queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen. A 4.
Higher.
Trying to go
four
all the way for the win. Oh, yes, she did it with a 5. Wow. Game one to the challenger and $100. Same two decks of cards will set up for game two. I almost said no on that. It looked like a 3 to me as I turned it over. Very nice win, Linda. And as remember, the same two decks of cards, the question to you, Linda. We asked 100 married women in the past month, have you said to your husband those immortal words, I told you so? How many women have said that to their husband?
I do it all the time, any chance I can get. I'm going to go with a middle-of-the-road number. Let's 67.
67, that's middle of the road, yes.
Well, little up middle of the road.
67 women have said, I told you so.
I don't think that's too smart to go around telling you that I told you so, so I'm going to have to say less than that.
You say lower.
Lower.
The actual number of married women who have said to their husband, I told you so, is 72, not lower. Linda. Well, Steve, I told you so. Linda, you're starting with a 10.
I want to change that 10.
Changing it to a 4.
Oh, better. Higher.
Higher than a 4. It is a jack.
Lower.
Lower than a jack. A three!
Oh, higher!
Higher than a three! A six!
Freeze
the hit. And Linda needs one card to become the new champion. Steve, you've got to make a comeback. Steve, we asked 100 men. Have you ever awakened, dressed for work, and then realized it was really your day off? How many men said that they've done that?
Believe it or not, that's happened to me, and I hate to go to work.
It's happened to me.
I'll say 33.
33 men have gotten all ready for work, and then said, wait a minute. Wrong
my
day.
Husband has never done that, nor my father. I would say it's a little lower.
You say lower?
Yes.
Well, the actual number of men who dressed for work on their day off is 26. It is a little lower. Linda.
Get rid of that six, please.
Big change, changing the six to...
Lower than the eight!
Lower for the championship, yes! Oh! Hey, we have a new champion. Congratulations, and Steve, you're leaving us with $2,000.
Thank you.
Good luck. Hope everything works out for you here.
Thank you, sir.
You're a nice gentleman. Steve Hanks. Thank you, Steve. Linda, come on down. Congratulations. Well, that's nice. You should be excited. Linda's going to get a crack at the big money right after this commercial break. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Back with our new champion, Linda Aldred. You're already ahead of the game. You got $200 for the match.
Yes.
Do you feel lucky?
I feel really lucky.
That's the way. Good. Let's do it. Let's really clean it up. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Yeah. Come on, Linda. Hop up there. Doggone it. We want to give away a bundle. Janice will start dealing out the cards. And again, it's a brand new deck of cards, all shuffled and cut. And I hope they're going to fall right for you. Seven cards up there. But you do feel lucky. You told me that, too. You're all set.
I feel lucky.
Remember that big bet where you must bet at least half the money? Let's get a lot of money up there for that big bet. Here's $200, Linda. Come on now, we're all with you. We'll start off with, remember, you've got a choice of two base cards. Your first one is a six.
Get rid of the six, please.
All right, let's make a good change now. Changing the six to a king.
I bet all of it lower than the king.
$200, lower than a king. Yes, with a nine, you've doubled it to four.
Okay, I bet $50 lower than the nine.
Minimum bet $50 lower than that middle card, the nine. And she's right for the six. $450.
Okay. I bet $100 higher than the six.
$100 higher than a six. Yes, the nine. $550. We're moving up. Well, I'm not sure if it's such a good card.
Change it, please.
Yeah, you can change it when you move up. We'll give you the other $200 of betting money. $750 and the chance to change that nine to a four.
Oh.
Better card.
I'm a gambler. I'm going to say $500 higher.
Big bet on that four.
Please.
$500 higher than a four. Yes.
$1,250. Okay. I don't like sevens. Sevens are supposed to be lucky, but they're not. $100 higher.
$100 higher than a seven. She's right again with a jack. $1,350.
Okay. I'm going to go $500 lower than the jack, please.
$500 lower than a jack?
Oh.
No, with a king.
Good sacrifice, though.
But with a king going up for the big bet, yeah, you've got $850.
I want to keep the king and bet all of it lower than the king.
All or nothing to double that $850 lower than a king.
$1,700.
And you were lucky, Linda. Good play. Come on down here. Did your football team make that much money?
No.
Well, we'll be back with the world's prettiest halfback right after this commercial break. Congratulations, everybody. Linda Aldred, our champion, with $1,900. And you just got out here, you were telling me, from Texas.
Mm-hmm. 6 months ago, we moved out here.
How are you enjoying it?
I love the weather.
Yeah.
No humidity in Bakersfield, anyway.
What does your husband do that you came out?
He works for a major oil company. He's a financial analyst.
Financial analyst? Oh, ho, ho. You've given him a little money to work with in the family now.
Definitely.
Linda will defend the title when next we meet on Card Sharks. Bye-bye for now. Have a good day.
One of our polling groups will receive a Philco 9-inch black and white portable TV to take almost anywhere. Plays on AC battery or car cigarette lighter complete with sunscreen and earphones. And some of our contestants will receive from Amity a man's leather set, featuring the genuine body Bill Folden Bandito cowhide, so soft and flexible it conforms to everybody Amity. And Hamilton Beach's revolutionary new 2001 Space Age Electronic Computer Blender. Touch controls for 16-speed selection timer, digital readouts from Hamilton Beach Scoville, and the selection of Tenti products. The great new building set from Hasbro. With Tenti, it's a snap to be a better builder. And West Clocks looks ahead in time. The smartly styled, compact, Big Ben, solid-state LED, digital AM, FM, instant on-clock radio. West Clocks by Tally Industries. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.